The Punahou Photography Department allows students to express themselves through the medium of film. Here's a look at what this exciting program has to offer.
I teach Photo 1 and I teach Photo 2. There's also an independent art class, which is also called Photography 3. And then we also have Art of Video 1 and Art of Video 2. And I'm also the yearbook advisor for Punahou School. In 1991, Punahou had renovated Powahi Hall. They completely had gutted this building, and they had redesigned the interior, and they had built a brand new darkroom and a photo lab. And the darkroom and photo lab that we have today is one of the best that I have seen in any high school in the United States, and I think it rivals many colleges and universities. Presently in the photo lab, there are many different sections. We have a photo classroom where there's demonstrations and lectures and slides. We do open critiques with the students and talk about our work and review it and analyze it, interpret it, evaluate it. In the classroom, we also have a small digital area where we can scan film. We also have a flatbed scanner, and then they can work on it, they can send it elsewhere, or they can print it out there. We have a front area in the photo lab that is kind of a multi-purpose room. So there's a light table where they can look at negatives. We have a color print processor where they can print out proofs. We have a dry mounting press. We have a paper dryer. As you go into the dark room, we have a couple of film rooms where students take negatives and they transfer them from a cassette to a light proof developing tank. We have a chemical room where all the chemical processes for developing negatives occurs. We also have a processor in that room for developing color negatives. And then we have the traditional darkroom. And in the traditional darkroom, that's where students can make proof sheets and enlargements in black and white. I started learning about photography probably before I started learning about anything else. I remember hours and hours as a kid sitting on the ground, going through encyclopedias, going through books, looking at pictures before I could read. And it was kind of like the world, and I was discovering the world through photography. And ultimately, you know, I'm pretty sure that's where it starts. What also made an impression on me on photography is it became part of my memory. So that there were things that I'd forgotten, but you look back at the photo albums from the family and the photography jogs your memory, and therefore you think, okay, this is what happened and this is what I remember. And is it really now what I remembered, or was it just because I remember the photograph, not the memory of it? Photography is a really interesting art form because it's something that a lot of us get involved with, a lot of us play with, a lot of us have seen and been involved with ever since we're kids, and you know, people of all ages do photography. And yet, for the most part, we don't think of it too seriously. And we take it for granted, and yet there is an art to it, and there is a power to it. It's very rare in this world of things that are constantly changing in which you can freeze a moment in time and keep that moment in time forever. And yet you can do that in photography. And so in our photo classes, I try to gear it for a technique so that students understand kind of the limitations of photography, but also the potential of it. We try to keep it very simple in the beginning to keep things, no pun intended, focused. And so we start with film, and we start with black and white photography. And I teach them how to master the cameras, how to use the chemistry, how to use the darkroom. I think what sets photography apart is how it empowers people. Drawing is a wonderful skill, and it's a wonderful art, and so is sculpture, and so is glass blowing, and so is so many other things that we can do as artists. In photography, you can hand a camera to a student, to a child, to a grandfather, to a monkey, and it can probably figure out how to push the trigger, and it creates something. And sometimes what it creates is unintentional, and sometimes what it creates is real. But the bottom line is it gives access to a lot of people the ability to express, to show the world as they view it. As we all know, digital photography is big and it's huge. And it's introducing a lot of people into photography that may not have explored it before. It is very easy to use and abuse. But the bottom line is the future is definitely going to be digital. And so in our photo classes, I'm beginning to introduce digital photography. But I do it cautiously, because there are things that film and traditional photography offers that at this point can't be replicated in digital photography. There's a carefulness and a purposefulness and a linearness to film photography that you can't experience in the same way with digital photography. I can give you a roll of 24 exposures of film and say, this is your assignment, let's see what you can do with it. Or I can give you a digital media and say, you can shoot countless times, as many as you want, you can erase and reshoot and reshoot and reshoot, it's infinite. You would think, given the second possibility, you could create much better work. But from what I've seen in classes and from students and individuals, that isn't always true. Quite often, if we know we only have 24 shots, our first shot, there's more care and attention put to it. We have 5 shots left. What are we going to do with those 5 shots? We're much more careful with that. But with that said, I do believe we're going to live in a world that has both film and digital, and it would be negligent not to introduce digital photography. There's so much to learn with that. And so the advanced photo students are introduced to digital photography and programs such as Adobe Photoshop.
During sophomore year, I took photo 1, and then junior year, I took photo 2 during the first semester, and I went on the photo trip to Molokai. And senior year, I did photo 3 as independent art, and I went to Kauai with the photo 2 kids that year. I take photography mainly because it's fun, but it also lets me like explore outside. Oh, I really like select stories. Like he would tell like weird things about his travels and from when he was working in LA with Hollywood. And besides that, I don't know, you really have to be in the class to really understand why it's so great.
I have a huge list of what I hope students will get out of any art class. And part of what it is the realization that what you do in art ultimately is for yourself. Ultimately, it's you should be working to please yourself, to what is important to you. But we don't live in a vacuum, and what you create is going to be viewed and potentially viewed by the entire world. And so you also need to be aware and conscious and purposeful that what you do is going to be seen and shared, and that what your intent is may not be communicated at all. And so you need to be aware of all the different interpretations of what people may take of what you're expressing and what you're showing. I hope students learn in my class that being a creative person means learning the rules, and once you learn the rules, how to break those rules. I think in an art class, what's important is understanding the balance between technique and content. That if you have great content but no technique, it's hard for people to appreciate it. If you have wonderful technique but you have no message, then it's an empty shell. And ultimately, you have to find a balance between these two things. And I hope you can do that in a photography class.